In the United States alone, there are more than 18 million people that own a skateboard, and it is in the top 10 most popular sports in the world. But can skateboarding be considered more than just a sport? Could it be considered an art?
It is very much an art. The city and the street culture and life, and they just kind of use everything around them. They integrate into the environment.
Culture that it's built up around it is one of art, of positive messages or socially conscious messages via graphic medium.
Never ever. There's no way. No. If anything, there is no correlation.
Is the act of skateboarding considered illegal?
On public property, you should, or even walk on public property, or push your kid in a four-wheel stroller, you should be able to ride a skateboard on that.
Well, then why don't you leave?
Okay.
Before I call the police.
Most of the downtown area is prohibited. As law enforcement, you have to be cautious not to stereotype people. And I could admit that I had a little bit of that going as far as the skateboard culture.
It's nice to know your rights, but the best advice you can get about cops is stay away from them. Avoid them. I mean, I went through the whole entire punk rock scene with riot after riot after riot and never got arrested because my dad taught me when you see a cop, you get away from the cop.
I mean, I've been in dialogue with plenty of property managers who end up at odds at that point. You're always going to see a residual line going down the top that will not come out.
To answer these questions, we have traveled to the birthplaces of skateboarding and into the most misunderstood city of Mexico.
Pues no es como lo pintan en las noticias. Ya ves que las noticias hablan mucho de que Tijuana es un desastre, que mataron a no sé cuántos, que gente balaceando.